Brief AAP history. Filipinos have never been known as militaristic people, unlike the Japanese, Germans, Mexicans, or Pakistanis. Also, many historians noted that fact that the early Filipino were brotherhood as warlike, but being warlike is different from being militaristic. In any event, Filipinos by nature are non-conformist individuals who are likely to resist regimentation. If forced to do so, they resort to radicalizing the authorities that try to enforce such compliance. This is both bone and bane to the Filipino character by being individualistic. Filipinos place a higher value on the individual human life and his rights. On the other hand, such an attitude erodes discipline, which is vital pressure for the evolution of nationhood. History cannot give us a program for the future, but it can give us a fuller understanding of ourselves and of our common humanity so that we can better face the future. Robert Penn Warren. The scope of these lessons are Battle of Mactan, the home ground and formal military consciousness during the uprising against Spain, Filipinos in Spanish military armed service, the first formal truly Filipino military organization, the Commonwealth Army from 1935 to 1945, the World War II, the Army of the Third Republic from 1946 to 1972, the martial law years in the Fourth Republic from 1972 to 1986, the Fifth Republic, attempted coups, and the AAP towards the 21st century during the administration of President Fidel B. Ramos. At the end of this lesson, the students are expected to refresh their minds on the specific details of the history of the Philippines, understand the events that lead to the establishment of the army in the AAP, and appreciate the lessons presented by the events that transpired in the past. The Spaniards first came to the Philippines on March 16, 1521, and tried to establish domination over ancestors. The battle between the native Filipinos and Magellanist men. Mactan, chieftain Lapu-Lapu and his warriors defeated Portuguese leader of the Spanish expedition, Captain General Ferdinand Magellan, on April 26, 1521. Lapu-Lapu's resistance to Spanish rule. The home ground and former military consciousness during the uprising against Spain. Units were formed on geographical or clan bases. The units of little training, poorly armed, and lacking in tactical leadership, organization, and logistical support. Significant of all uprising in the Dagohoy Rebellion, which lasted for almost 85 years from 1744 to 1821. In this event, we can summarize that we have one of the first institution-oriented military organizations in our history. Filipinos in Spanish military armed service. Spaniards applied the strategy of conquer, divide, and rule. The first formal truly Filipino military organization is the Kataas-taasan Kagalang-galangang Katipunan ng Mga Anak ng Bayan, or the KKK, was established. The revolutionary government was organized in the Heteros Convention in 1987. The designation of General Artemio Ricarte as the first captain, commanding general of the revolution, and General Antonio Luna as Minister of War and Director of Operations on March 22, 1897, were among the agreed appointments. Provisions were made for the formalization of artillery, cavalry, ordnance, commissary, quartermaster, signal, medical, and dental services. The infant Philippine Army had its baptism of fire as an army of the Independent Republic during the war against Americans on February 4, 1899. The Americans considered the surrender of General Miguel Malbar of Batangas as the end of Philippine campaign. However, Filipino resistance continued even up to 1910. General Ricardi died in 1945, still a defiant patriot. Others who continued to resist were Macario Sacay and General Simeon Ola. After 1910, serious armed resistance declined and Philippine Army had ceased to exist as current fighting force. The Commonwealth Army from 1935 to 1945. The Commonwealth of the Philippines was inaugurated in 1935 with the passing of the tidings Magdapilo in 1934. The Philippine Army of the Commonwealth was reactivated on January 11, 1936 with Philippine constabulary elements as its nucleus. Retired American General Douglas MacArthur acted as advisor of the reconstituted Philippine Army, who was made as a Field Marshal of the Commonwealth on June 19, 1936. President Quezon hoped that MacArthur's stature and influence on the U.S. government will result favorable actions as to the availability of defense equipment and special procurement prices for other items, but it did not materialize. U.S. President Franklin Roosevelt called into the service of 2 regular and 10 reserve divisions of Philippine Army to be part of the USAPE on July 26, 1941. The World War II. World War II broke out in the Philippines when the Japanese bombed various targets in the country on December 8, 1941. The country was left open for invasion after the destruction of the American naval fleet in Hawaii and the U.S. Army Air Corps in the Philippines. The Japanese Potent Army under General Homma landed in Lingayen, Pangasinan on December 10, 1941. MacArthur implemented an old naval defense plan, Orange 3. The failure of all defense plans led to the infamous Death March. The Army of the Third Republic from 1946 to 1972. Philippine Army was in a semi-chaotic state after the war. President Manuel Rojas recognized the armed forces by issuing Executive Order No. 92 dated October 4, 1947. Army was renamed the Armed Forces of the Philippines with its headquarters called the National Defense Forces. 4 military areas were activated, replacing the 10 military districts of the Free Warriors on May 6, 1948. The military training commander, the offshore patrol, and the air corps were elevated to major commands. In 1950, 7 army commands and 26 battalion combat teams, or the BCTs, were organized. 5 of these BCTs took turns in serving with the Philippine Expeditionary Forces to Korea, and the 5th took. President Quirino issued Executive Order No. 359, which provides for the creation of the 4 major services of the AFP. The Scout Rangers were organized by Team Captain Rafael Helito to face the Hulk Communists. The 1st Scout Ranger Regiment was deactivated in 1959 because the need for the Scout Rangers no longer existed. The headquarters, Philippine Army, was organized with Brigadier General Lenceo Tan as Commanding General Philippine Army on July 1, 1957. In the late 1960s, Philippine Army was utilized as a national defense force and as a nation builder. The Army Corps of Engineers with the 51st Engineer Brigade as the nucleus was organized in the early 1970s. The ugliest episode involving the military was the infamous Haveda massacre in 1968. For the period, Philippine Army has 1 regular division, which is the 1st Infantry Tabak Division, three independent brigades, which are the 2nd, 4th, and 5th brigades, a supporting anti-tank, artillery, and independent armor company-sized units. The martial law years and the Fourth Republic from 1972 to 1986. On September 21, 1972, President Marcos proclaimed a state of martial law all over the country. Due to the threats of insurgency of NPA and MNLF, Marcos expanded the army from 29,000 in 1972 to 65,000 in 1986. And strengthened the three independent brigade to full divisions. Units like the Philippine Army Light Armor Regiment, later renamed Brigade, was organized, and the 1st Scout Ranger Regiment was reactivated to enable the AAP, particularly the Army, to accomplish its mission. The early martial law years saw the Army fighting on two fronts. The secessionists in the south mobilized the reservists. The communist guerrillas in the north, particularly in Isabela, is the best troops. The AAP redirected its main effort to the south with the decline of the NPA and CPP, with the threat to the north reduced. Despite suffering 6,000 fatalities, it inflicted several defeats to MNLF and forced it to negotiate with the Tripoli agreements in 1976 as the result. The mismanagement of the economy by the Marcos government and the excesses committed by the members of his family and officials made the period of stability and progress short-lived. Unfortunately, the military, especially the PC, became the primary institutions for such actions. Military lost much of its professionalism when it fell to the control of political general whose primary qualification was loyalty to the administration. The image of the AAP started to be haunted by human rights issues, especially when the chief oppositionist to Marcos, Senator Benigno Aquino, was assassinated on August 21, 1983. At the Manila International Airport. During this time, the NPA regained its lost strength, reaching its zenith in 1986 with 25,000 guerrillas from only 3,000 in 1979. It was this time that the professional, technical, and ethical standards of the army fell, with casualties exceeding 1,000 a year for several years, killing only half as many communist guerrillas. Resentment within the military grew, and the reform of the AAP movement had its beginning, headed by Colonel Gringo Honasan. A snap election was called by President Marcos on February 7, 1986, after 7 years as legitimate president, 9 years dictator, and over 4 years authoritarian president. The election was chaotic and bloody, and up to now, the result is an open question. Then Defense Minister Enrile and Lieutenant General Ramos withdrew support to Marcos and proclaimed Corazon Aquino as the rightful president. Oppositionists Agapito Aquino and Manila Archbishop Jaime Cardinal Sin urged the people to surround the camps in order to protect the Enrile and Ramos forces from Marcos troops using their bodies. That's what later became known as EDSA People Power Revolution. The PIP Republic. The People Power Revolution of 1986 restored the degree of faith of Filipino people in the AAP, but most of the members of the AAP found it difficult to accept Mrs. Aquino as the president and the commander-in-chief. The war against NPA is being lost and casualties continued to mount. To top it all, elements of the AAP were involved in anti-government actions, and there are 5 attempted coups and 3 rebellions that were suppressed. Attempted coups. Manila Hotel Incident, July 7, 1986. Active informal military personnel led by Brigadier General Jose Maria Carlos Somel and Marcos running mate Arturo Tolentino, supported by pro-Marcos civilians, occupied Manila Hotel and tried to stage a people power revolution of their own, but failed only after a few days. God Save the Queen incident on November 1986. Channel 4 incident on January 1987. August 28, 1987, COP. Colonel Hunasan, supported by RAM troops and elements of the Army Scout Rangers and other AAP units, occupied the General Headquarters building and parts of Camp Aguinaldo, where GXQ building was destroyed by F-5 jets and Trojan. December 1-9, 1989, COP. This is the bloodiest and the most serious challenge ever faced by the government from discontented military elements, and broke out simultaneously all over the country, with more serious ones in Metro Manila and Mactan Air Base in Cebu. Involved were several Scout Ranger and Pantry and Armor units, Marines, Air Force, pilots in planes and Navy units, active generals and flag officers. Malacanang Palace itself was bombed 11 a.m. RAM is a reformed armed forces movement, later renamed Revolutionaryong Alyansa Makabayan Soldiers of the Filipino People. Air assets controlled the air over Metro Manila, and YOU, or the Young Officers Union, officer leading the COP, sent an ultimatum to President Aquino to surrender, but the president refused. At 2 p.m., U.S. Air Force F-4 Phantom jets made several persuasion flights, hereby discouraging RAM's SF planes from flying missions over the capital. The PAP F-5 pilots still loyal to the government, who were unable to make action against their former comrades, now took the air and destroyed the RAM SFP planes on the ground at Sangley Point. While these were being refueled in BR, control of the air reverted back to the government forces. The Packet Rebellion by military elements. Black Forest incidents, April 1987. Former military personnel hijacked a fire truck and rammed the Army Detention Center near Gate 1 of Port Bonifacio and set some of their comrades free. Later, they occupied headquarters Philippine Army and took several officers and EP as hostages. The commanding general Philippine Army, Major General Rodolfo Canyes, ordered the Port Scout Ranger Company to storm HPA and recaptured it. Aguinaldo Caper, March 4, 1990. Former PC Colonel and incumbent in Cagayan Valley Governor at the time of the incident, Rodolfo Aguinaldo could declare his non-recognition of President Aquino's government as legitimate government of the country. Supported by active and former military personnel, native tribesmen, and Kafbu militiamen loyal to him, he surrounded the hotel occupied by AAP J7 Brigadier General Oscar Florendo and his party, who came to gigaraw with him. Brigadier General Florendo was negotiating with Aguinaldo's representative at the ground floor of the hotel when a firefight broke out between the rebel elements and the members of Florendo's party under Colonel Emiliano Templo, who were occupying the second floor. Florendo was killed in the government launched a massive mopping up operation in Cagayan, using the Marines brought over from Manila. The rebel forces disintegrated with minimal bloodshed and rebellion ended. Noble Uprising, October 1990. Colonel Alexander Noble escaped from detention, made his way to Mindanao, and won over several elements of the 402nd Infantry Brigade, including elements of the 23rd IB, Tulabent, and others in the occupied part of Camp Evangelista in Cagayan de Oro City. The establishment of PNP. The 1987 Constitution mandated further changes in the structure of the armed forces. The existing militia, the Civilian Home Defense Force, was ordered disbanded and was replaced beginning in 1988 with new auxiliary force under direct control of military regulars. More significantly, the 1987 Constitution calls for the government to establish and maintain one police force, which shall be national and scope in civilian in character. Pursuant to the mandate, Aquino signed a law directing that the Philippine Constabulary, one of the four military services, be combined with the Civilian Integrated National Police to form the Philippine National Police. The process of integrating the two organizations under a newly created Department of Interior and Local Government began on January 1, 1991. At present, the Army is facing potentially renewed threat of secessionation in the South. It is brought by greater belligerence being displayed by the Moro Islamic Revolution Front, a breakaway group from the Moro National Liberation Front, the fundamentalist Abu Sayyaf group, and the subsequent counteractions by Christian vigilant groups out of the protect themselves from any outbreak of fighting. At the same time, the entire AEP is undertaking a modernization program that will upgrade the country's external defense capability. The signing of peace agreement between Norm Misuari of the MNLF and the government of President Ramos is a positive development, although it faces considerable opposition, especially from the Christian communists in Mindanao. AEP towards the 21st century. Were the Ramos Administration. Under the amnesty program in the supervision of the National Amnesty Commission, amnesty was offered to civilian rebels to return to the folds of law and for reinstatement for those in the military. During this time, the AEP is modernizing its administrative system with the introduction and use of computers in a massive scale and the updating of its training and education programs. Needed weapons and equipment were given priority to procure. As a senior major service branch of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Philippine Army remains a conventional military force with infantry, artillery, and armor as its major arms, supported by engineers and service support. Its organizations are divisions, brigades, and battalions. Its weapons range from Scorpion light tanks to armored personnel carrier and various artillery pieces to M14 and M16. Its tactics involve along the unconventional warfare based on the lessons from the Vietnam War, while others from local experiences. The history of the Armed Forces of the Philippines is the defection of the fighting traditions of the Filipinos. It is a record of their bravery, sacrifices, and their undaunted and persistent struggle to defend our country's freedom. Ten years after the Edsa Revolution, the AAP has regained prestige and credibility in the eyes of the people and government. The rebellions and the human rights issues were slowly being resolved. The communist challenge has been taken in greater discipline and being resolved. The communist challenge has been beaten back in the greater discipline and professionalism repeatedly displayed by the members of the military. Establishment has earned admiration from critical observers, both here and abroad. Of course, the AEP is still faced with serious problems such as organization, equipment, pay and allowances, facilities, training, and more effective leadership, especially at the tactical level. But with greater awareness and a higher sense of duty among the military, We are confident that we are on the right path towards the achievement of modern, effective, professional, and truly popular armed forces of the people. Thank you.